Hey guys, welcome to Laratips. In today's video, we'll be looking at 5 new things that are added to Laravel version 9.1.0. This is the first weekly release that has been released after the major version Laravel 9. So let's have a look what's inside it. The first thing that has been added is this disabled directive. Let's see what it does. I am here in the laratips.test website and here I have this button. So I'll just write here @disabledTrue. And if I come here and just reload, then you can see here it is now disabled. And let me just show you this button over here. It has added this disabled attribute over here. And if I just add false like this and hit reload, then that is gone. This is just like that checked and selected directive that has been added to Laravel version 9. Now this disabled is also added. You don't have to check if and else condition over here. The second thing that has been added is this support for passing array as the second parameter for the group method in that route service provider. Okay, suppose here we have this web.php file and also we have this user.php file. And here I have user as a route name. There are two route files. And if you want to manage huge routes in your project into multiple route files, then I have already created on how to do that. Basically, it will also be shown over here. But if you want to look over that particular video, then I'll be leaving the link of that video just below that like button. Okay, we have this user and web. And now if I go here in the route service provider, then before I had to do it like this. I had to duplicate this and just write it like this. And if I come here in the browser and just refresh, then I'll be able to see this user home, whatever I have returned from that route. But now instead of duplicating everything here, we can see everything is same over here. Only this file is different. So in that case, now we can just do here, just remove this and add array over here like this in the group. And we can just remove this. Now, if I come here and reload, then the result will be same. Third thing that has been added, as you can see here, it is written 8.x, but it has been added recently and it is added to both 8 and 9 version. The firstOr function to the belongsToMany relationship. I have this user roles belongsToMany relationship. And in the home controller, I have this like this. Auth user roles firstOr. This firstOr method is added. This is new. And if I go here in the role user controller and let me just add it over here 11, there is no any role for this user. And I'll just remove this and add it like this for now. And here in the browser, we'll be able to see that there is nothing, which means it is returning null since there is no role for this user. But let's say if this user doesn't have any role, this is in case of belongs to many relationship. Okay, so if the user doesn't have any role, then we can just pass the default role for that user. Here I have just written role first, but you can pass any default role from here. We can just pass a closure to it and return that role, or you can return anything over here. But obviously passing a role or a default role is a better option. So here, if I just reload, then I'll get the first role, or sorry, the default role over here. But let's say this user already has a role and the role is of ID 3. And I'll just reload here, then I'll get that role over here. The next thing that has been added is this filtering for the route list by domain. Let me just comment this out and let me go here in the web.php here at the bottom. I have this route domain google.com/home. And if I come here, PHP artisan route list like this, then I'll be able to see that Google domain over here like this. But let's say we only want to filter by this domain. Here it can be anything. I have just written Google for example, but you can write any one of your domain. But let's say we only want the route list of that domain. Then now we can do like this, route list --- domain and the name of that domain, which in our case is google.com. Now it will only show the route list of that domain. And finally, the last thing that has been added is this doesn't contain to the higher order proxies in the collection. Let me just show you that over here in the home controller like this. So here in the user model, I have is admin and is normal. And again, this is not the roles that I just showed you from the relationship. This is a different thing that I was just testing around. So here is this is admin and is normal over here, the methods. And here doesn't contain. Before we could do it like this, but we already have this is admin and is normal methods on the user model. But we are accessing this admin again Look, you can see here we already have this, and we are again accessing it like this. We are leaking the column information to the controller. So we could do it like this. So I am taking latest 5 users, and I am checking whether admin is over there or not. And if I show you over here, the latest 5 users, there is no admin. There are only normal users. And here in the browser, just reload, then it will give me true because there are no admins. It doesn't contain any admin. But now instead of this, I can just do contains is admin like this. Doesn't contain is admin. This is the higher order proxy. And I have already made a detailed tutorial about this thing in my Laravel basics collection. You can have a look at that. I'll be leaving the link of that also just below that like button. Now, if I come here and reload, then I'll get the same thing. Here, it is not leaking this type equals to admin, the database information in the controller.